In this session, we are going to determine the mutual inductance of a coil. The circuit connection is very simple. In this circuit diagram, we have two circuits. One is primary circuit and another one is secondary circuit. In primary circuit, it has primary coil, a small resistor which is connected between the two terminals A and B, and it has a battery and a key with this rheostat. By adjusting this rheostat, we can keep a steady current. The current can be measured by using this ammeter. I can vary the current in the primary circuit by using this rheostat. If I close the key, then the circuit will be closed. In secondary circuit, it has a secondary coil and a ballistic galvanometer. The secondary circuit is initially open. Okay, now let us take MB, the mutual inductance of the coil. R is the resistance of the secondary circuit. For this entire circuit, the total resistance is capital R. And in primary circuit, let this I naught be the maximum current. Initially, what we need to do is, we need to connect the terminals C and D. The C and D will be connected. And by closing the key K, this ballistic galvanometer shows deflection. The deflection is due to the mutual inductance. Here I have a coil P and here I have coil S. This is primary coil and this is secondary coil. Even though there is no connection to this primary circuit, by connecting C and D, this galvanometer shows deflection. That deflection is due to the induced EMF in the secondary circuit. Here, the induced EMF across the secondary coil can be written as M into di by dt. This induced EMF can be written as induced current into resistance of the secondary circuit, so which is equal to this M di by dt. The induced EMF in the secondary circuit is nothing but induced current into resistance of the secondary circuit, which is equal to this M di by dt. Therefore, I can write induced current as M by R into di by dt, where this R is resistance of the secondary circuit. Let us take this as equation 1. If dq amount of charge flows through secondary in the time interval of dt, then I can write dq as dq is equal to induced current into dt. This is from the definition. Dq is equal to induced current into dt. What is this induced current? This induced current is nothing but this M by R di by dt. Okay, let us substitute that induced current. So I will get dq is equal to M by R di by dt into dt. This dt will get cancelled. If current rises from 0 to maximum value I naught in the secondary circuit, then I can integrate this expression. So here integration of dq is equal to m by r is a constant, and here I is variable, I is changing, I is increasing from 0 to maximum current I naught. So limits from 0 to I naught into di. So here we'll get q is equal to m divided by r into I naught. If this amount of charge flows through the ballistic galvanometer in the secondary circuit, let theta 1 be the first deflection observed in ballistic galvanometer. From the theory of ballistic galvanometer, we have this relation. If q amount of charges flows through a BG and theta 1 is the first deflection observed, then q can be written as q is equal to t by 2 pi c by abn theta 1 into 1 plus lambda by 2. Now I have these two expressions, q is equal to this, and if q amount of flow charge flows through BG, then q can be written as q is equal to this. Here from these two expressions, left hand sides are equal, so I can equate right hand side. So m by r I naught is equal to t by 2 pi c by abn theta 1 into 1 plus lambda by 2. Let us take this as equation 2. Now let us move on to this circuit. Now let us disconnect the connection C and D. I will remove the connection C and D. After removing, I will connect the terminal C to A and D to B. Now this secondary circuit is directly connected across this small R. When this C is connected to A and D is connected to B, this ballistic galvanometer shows deflection. When the circuit is directly connected, whatever the deflection produced by the BG, let us take that deflection as theta 2. That theta 2 will be obtained by pressing this key, by closing or by connecting C to A, D to B and closing the key K. The potential difference across R can be written as I naught into R, where this I naught is the maximum current in the primary circuit. Therefore, the current flowing through this small resistance R is I naught. Therefore, potential difference across this small R is I naught into R. Therefore, the current through the secondary circuit, can be written as this potential difference divided by resistance of the secondary circuit. So that is what the current through the secondary circuit, which is equal to I naught into small r divided by capital R. We know this equation ABN I is equal to C theta. Now let us use this equation for this situation, for this circuit. ABN as it is, I is nothing but current through the secondary circuit, which is equal to C theta 2. Theta 2 is the deflection produced in the ballistic galvanometer. ABN into current through the secondary circuit is I naught into R divided by capital R. After simplifying this, after substituting and simplifying, I will get I naught into R divided by capital R is equal to C theta 2 divided by ABN. Let us have this as equation 3. Now I have two equations. This is equation 2 and this is equation 3. I can divide equation 2 by equation 3. After dividing, this R will get cancelled, I naught will get cancelled, and rearranging the expression, the final expression will be capital M is equal to R T divided by 2 pi theta 1 divided by theta 2 into 1 plus lambda by 2. Here 2 pi is constant. By knowing the value of R T deflections theta 1 and theta 2 and logarithmic decrement lambda, I can calculate the mutual inductance. Thank you.